We are in a chapter called A Pair of Linear Equation in Two Variables. This is one of the finest chapter, easiest chapter to score marks. We are going to get 8 marks. And we completed all the methods of solving a pair of linear equation in two variables. At present, we are in exercise 3.6, that is the last exercise. To get 8 marks, we have to do some work. We have to understand some of the information. The information number one, what is a linear equation? Linear equation is a first degree equation, which is the standard form of a linear equation in two variables. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. What is the type of graph we are going to get when we plot a linear equation? We get a straight line. Pair of linear equation in two variables, standard form. A1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. A2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. When we plot a graph for a pair of linear equation in two variables, we get two straight lines. The lines may be intersecting lines, parallel lines, or coincident lines. How to identify? If a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, intersecting lines. a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, but not equal to c1 by c2, parallel lines. a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2, coincident lines. For the intersecting lines, we get unique solution. For a parallel lines, we don't get solutions. And coincident line, we get infinite solutions. Then the methods of plotting graph. We know how to solve, how to write graph for a pair of linear equations. We solve that exercise. Then in the graph method, there is one disadvantage. What is that disadvantage? If the coefficients are irrational numbers, we are finding it difficult to plot graph. Therefore, we go for algebraic method. But which is the best method? Graphical method is the best method. Algebraic method is only meant for finding the solution. We get solution only for intersecting lines. We don't get solution for parallel lines and coincident lines. We get infinite solutions. Therefore, algebraic methods are used only to find the unique solution, that is intersecting lines. How many methods are mentioned in the textbook? Three methods: substitution method, elimination method, and cross multiplication method. Substitution method and elimination method are very easy. You already used these two methods in your previous classes, 8th standard, 9th standard. The new method what they included in this 10th standard is cross multiplication method. How to write the formula and apply. There is no hard and fast rule. We have to apply the same method to solve any problem. Any method you can adopt. Graphical method means graph only you have to write. Solve means you can adopt any method. Which method you are well versed in, that particular method you can solve the pair of linear equation in two variables. The best method is elimination method. Right, now we are in exercise 3.6. This is a exercise where they are given a complicated type of problems, application type of problems, and we can solve the problem by any of the method what we select. Right, I do majority of the problem I do by elimination method only. Now we start solving the problems of exercise 3.6. For the public examination is concerned, I don't think so this exercise is that much important or not, but for completion of the one particular unit, I solve the problems of exercise 3.6. This is called solving a pair of linear equation in the reducible form, because the equation may not look like a linear pair, linear equation. We have to reduce to the linear pair and then we have to solve. Therefore, little lengthier problem, all problems are for 3 marks. Therefore, concentrate, practice, and what you have to do, keep your textbook. Keep your textbook. Even for any video, whenever you wanted to see video, keep your textbook, see, understand where it is in the textbook, write down, and you have to make your notes, right? Now you write. We are in exercise 3.6. See, exercise 3.6, solve the following pairs of equation by reducing them to a pair of linear equation. He is given a pair of equations. First thing is we have to reduce to a pair of linear equation, then we have to solve. So
solve is we have to find the value of x and y. See children, when we see this type of problem, it is when you see only we can understand, directly we can't solve this. Why we can't directly solve? Because they are given 1 by 2x plus 1 by 3y is equal to 2. Suddenly what we can do is, we take LCM and add and cross multiply. But when we take LCM, we get xy. Xy becomes another variable. We can't take xy. We should take only two variables, x and y. We should not include third variable. Therefore, we can't do this problem solution by taking LCM. I repeat once again, why we can't take LCM? When you take LCM, it becomes 6xy is the LCM. 6xy is the LCM means you already have a variable called x, there is another variable called y, then we are going to get one more variable, that is xy, therefore it becomes an equation of three variables. Now we wanted to solve the problems of equations of pair. Pair of linear equation is two variables. Therefore, what I do is, see here, this problem, I write it like this. 1 by 2x, I write this as half of 1 by x. 1 by 2x is written as half into 1 by x plus this as 1 by 3 of 1 by y is equal to 2. This is the first equation, modification and y. You have to write. Now this is 1 by 3 of 1 by x. 1 by 3 of 1 by x plus 1 by 2 of 1 by y is equal to 13 by 6. 13 by 6. Now what I do is, I consider this 1 by x, the complete 1 by x as p. Let 1 by x is equal to p. I consider 1 by x as p and 1 by y as q. 1 by x as p, 1 by y as q. What I did? I made 1 by x as p and 1 by y as q. See the first equation. Here half is there, 1 by x is there. I consider 1 by x as p, therefore this becomes p by 2. This becomes p by 2 plus this is 1 by 3 into 1 by y. 1 by y is q, therefore it is q by 3 is equal to 2. This is my first equation. See the second equation. 1 by 3 of 1 by x. 1 by x is equal to p, therefore it is p by 3 plus this is 1 by 2 of 1 by y. 1 by y is equal to q, therefore it is q by 2 is equal to 13 by 6. 13 by 6. Now I modify the equation. Now I can take the LCM because variables are not there. Therefore I can take the LCM. Therefore the first equation, see, I written the equations 1. This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Don't get confused. Now we modify the equation. What is p? P is equal to 1 by x. What is q? 1 by y. Now see, the LCM of these two is 6. 6. 6 divided by 2 is 3. 3 into p is 3p plus 6 divided by 3 is 2. 2 into q is 2q is equal to 2. When I cross multiply this, 6 into 2 is 12. 3p plus 2q is equal to 12. This is my first equation. Now see how many times I have to reduce it. Now I got a pair of linear equation in two variables. Which are the variables? P and Q are the variables. Second problem. Second equation. 3 and 2, LCM is 6. 6 divided by 3 is 2, 2 into P is 2P. Plus 6 divided by 2 is 3, 3 into Q is 3Q. 3Q is equal to 13 by 6. In this equation, both the sides we have 6 as denominator, therefore we can eliminate them. We can 6, we can cancel. Therefore, we get the second equation as 2P plus 3Q is equal to 13. This is my second equation. Second equation. See how many times I modify. First equation I modify like this, again I modify. Finally, I got a pair of linear equation in two variables, and variables are P and Q. But I know that P is equal to 1 by X, Q is equal to 1 by Y. That I transfer in the last equation. Now, using these two pair of linear equation, I am going to find the value of P and Q. The next step is, I write the equation 3P plus 2Q is equal to 12 on equation. 2P plus 3Q is equal to 13 is the second equation. Now I solve by elimination method. Which method? Elimination method. See, here 3 is there, here 2 is there. Therefore, what I do is, I multiply this equation by 2 and I multiply this equation by 3 to equate their coefficients. When I multiply this, 2 into 3, 6p plus 2 into 2, 4q is equal to 2 into 12, 24. Now 3. 3 into 2p, 6p. I equated the coefficient. Plus 3 into 3 is 9q and 13 threes are 39. Now change of sign, this should be minus, 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 plus 6p minus 6p cancels, plus 4q minus 9q means minus sign of the bigger number, minus. 9 minus 4 is 5, 5q. 24 minus 39, sign of the bigger number means minus. Subtract 24 from 39, you get 15. 39 minus 24 is 15. Minus 15. Therefore, q is equal to minus 15 by minus 5. Q is equal to 3. 5 ones are 5 threes. Q is equal to 3. Right? Q is equal to 3. Now what we have to do? We have to substitute this value of Q in any one of the equations. The next step. Substitute. Q is equal to how much? We got 3. In equation 1. The final stage of the equation 1 is this. This is equation 1. I write equation 1. 3 plus 3p plus 2q is equal to 12. We got q as 3. In the place of q, I write 3. 3p plus 2 of 3 is equal to 12. 3p, 2 into 3 is 6, is equal to 12. 3p is equal to 12. This 6 has to be transferred to that side. Minus 6. 3p is equal to 12 minus 6 is 6. P is equal to 6 by 3. P is equal to 2. 3 ones are 3 twos. P is equal to 2. Now I got value of q and value of p. But the still problem is there. Why? Because we have to find the value of x and y. Now, but p is equal to, what is p? P is equal to 1 by x. P is equal to 1 by x. Understood? P is equal to 1 by x. Therefore, p is equal to 2. 2 is equal to 1 by x. Cross multiply. 2x is equal to 1. Therefore, x is equal to 1 by 2.
x is equal to half. I got the value of x.
X is equal to half.
Still I want to find the value of what? Y. Then we have taken q is equal to 1 by y.
Q is equal to 1 by y.
What is the value of q? We got 3. 3 is equal to 1 by y. Cross multiply. 3y is equal to 1. Therefore, y is equal to 1 by 3. This is the answer for y. Therefore, x is equal to 1 by 2. Y is equal to 1 by 3 is the answer for this particular problem.
This problem is very nice. This type of problem you have to practice because it improves your skill. Second problem of the first main question, exercise 3.6. We are solving the pairs of linear equation by reducing the given equation, reducible form. See the problem. 2 by root x plus 3 by root y is equal to 2. 4 by root x minus 9 by root y is equal to minus 1. Wherever we find variables in the denominator, we have to reduce it. Therefore, the reduction part is here root x is there. Therefore, I can write this equation as modification. The first modification is 2 of 1 by root x. 2 of 1 by root x, this one, plus this is 3 of 1 by root y. We have to bring both the equations having same type of variables, that's all. Is equal to, this is the first equation I modified. The second equation is 4 of 1 by root x minus 9 of 1 by root y is equal to minus 1. See now, both the equations having same type of variables. Now I change. Let 1 by root x, 1 by root x is there, I write it as t, 1 by root x as t, and 1 by root y as q, any variable you can take, 1 by root x as t, 1 by root y as q. Now what I do is, I substitute the 1 by root x is there, in this place I write t, in this place I write q, therefore the equation what it becomes different. See, the first equation 2 into 1 by root x means it becomes 2p plus 3 into 1 by root y. 1 by root y is equal to q, therefore this 3q is equal to 2. See, very nice it became. It is a linear equation in two variables, it looks like that. Equation 1, second one, 4p minus 9q is equal to minus 1, is equal to minus 1. Wherever 1 by root x is there I replace p. Wherever 1 by root y is there I replace q. Now I got two equations. This problem is easy. You know it. Now these two are pair of linear equations in two variables. Variables are p and q. Now we have to find these values of p and q. I go for elimination method. I already told you elimination method is the best method. See here, this is 4p is there, here 2p is there. To make this as 4, I should multiply the first equation by 2. That much only enough. If I multiply the first equation by 2, it becomes 4. This also 4, subtract, cancels. Therefore, the first method is I want to multiply the first equation by 2. There is no need to multiply the second equation is multiplied by 1. There is no need to write that. Now, first equation, don't get confused. The second next step it is 2 into 2, 4p plus 3 into 2 is 6q is equal to 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 2 is 4. Then, second equation as it is 4p minus 9q is equal to minus 1. We are subtracting minus plus
4p minus 4p cancels, plus 6q plus 9q, it becomes plus 15q. 9 plus 6 is 15. Then 4 plus 1, 5. 4 plus 1 is 5. Therefore, 15q is equal to 5. Therefore, q is equal to 5 by 15. 5 by 15. 5 divided by 15. Q is equal to 5 1s are 5 3s are. Q is equal to 1 by 3. Q is equal to what? 1 by 3. I got Q is equal to 1 by 3. Now what I do is I substitute the value of Q to any one of the equation and then go to find the solution. Right. Now see. Substitute Q is equal to how much we have? 1 by 3 in equation 1. Equation 1. 2p plus 3q is equal to 2. That is the equation 1. Now in the place of q, I write 1 by 3. 2p plus 3 or 1 by 3. Nice problem it is, because you can cancel this. Is equal to 2. Now here 3 ones are. Therefore it becomes 2p plus 1 is equal to 2. Now I transfer onto that side. 2p is equal to 2 minus 1. 2p is equal to 1. P is equal to 1 by 2. P is equal to 1 by 2. Now I know the value of P. I know the value of Q. But I want the value of X and Y. Therefore what I do is. But. Once let. Next let but. But P is equal to 1 by X. 1 by root X. P is equal to 1 by root X. What is the value of P I got? I got half. Therefore, half is equal to 1 by root X. Numerator is equal to numerator, means denominator is equal to denominator. Therefore, 2 is equal to root X. To get X, we have to square that. Therefore, x is equal to 4. Try to understand how by squaring both sides. If you square both sides, root x whole square is x. 2 square is 4. X is equal to 4 is 4. Next, q is equal to 1 by root y. We only taken this. What is the value of q? We got 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is equal to 1 by root y. Numerator same, means denominator is also same in the proportion. Therefore 3 is equal to root y. Squaring both sides. Therefore y is equal to 9. 3 square is 9, root y whole square is 1. The answer is y is equal to 9. X is equal to 4. What we have to do is, you have to write along with me. Don't see simply the video. You are making notes. The notes is for you. When we write on the board, you have to write and make your notes. Third problem of first main question of exercise 3.6. We are in the reducible form. See the third problem. 4 by x plus 3 y is equal to 14. 3 by x minus 4y is equal to 23. Here what I have. The only x is in the denominator. Y is not in the denominator. Therefore, y we can keep it as it is. But this x should be changed. Anything which is a numerator, we don't have any problem. Whenever a variable is in the denominator, then we have to take LCM. When we take LCM, this becomes xy. Therefore, we should not do that. What we have to do is, we have to reduce this one, and this is it as it is. Therefore, what I do is, the first step is, this one I write, first term I write 4 of 1 by x. First term I write it as 4 of 1 by x. Second term I don't modify because it is in the numerator. 3y is equal to 14.
And the second problem, the second equation, 3 of 1 by x, 3 of 1 by x minus, I don't change this variable y because it is in the numerator, I keep it as y only, is equal to 23. Now I change this 1 by x as p, but I don't change this y as q, right? Let p is equal to 1 by x or 1 by x is equal to p. Now what I do is, I change, first equation becomes 4 p, 4 of 1 by x, 1 by x is equal to p, therefore 4 p plus, this is 3 y is equal to 14. Second one is 3p, 1 by x is p, minus 4y is equal to 23. Now I got two equations, equation 1, equation 2. Now we have to simplify this, we have to find the solution for this. We go for elimination method. Elimination method, we have to equate the coefficients. Here 4 is there, here 3 is there. What I do is, I multiply the first equation by 3 and second equation by 4. Therefore, this is into 3, first equation multiplied by 3, second equation is multiplied by 4. By that, we can equate the coefficients. 3 into 4, 12. 3 into 3, 9 equals 14 into 3, 10 into 3 is 30, 4 into 3 is 12, therefore it is 42. Next is second equation, 4 into 3, 12p, we equated the coefficients, minus 4 into 4, 16y equals 4 into 23, 24s are 80, 3 4s are 12, 92 becomes 6. Or 4 into 3 is 12, 1, 4 2s are 8 plus 1 is 9. Multiplication you have to learn. Now I subtract. I subtract and I have to change the sign. Okay. Plus 12p minus 12p, I cancel. Plus 4 power positive, 9 plus 16 is 25, 25y, 9 plus 16 is 25. Here what happened, minus is, minus 92 plus 42, from 92 you have to subtract 42, from 92 you have to subtract 42, you get 50, but which 50 it is, minus 50, why, because here minus is there. Therefore, y is equal to minus 50 by 25. Y is equal to minus 2. Y is equal to minus 2. Y minus 2, 25 ones are 25 twos. That's all. Y value is over. There is no need to substitute. Why? Because we directly got it. Now, with the help of y, we are going to find the value of p. Then, with the help of p, we are going to find the value of x. That way, we have to go. Now, the second step is, substitute y is equal to minus 2 in equation 1. Always go for equation 1 only. But which is the equation 1? 4p plus 3y is equal to 14. We got y is equal to minus 2. 4p plus 3 of minus 2 is equal to 14. 40 minus, plus into minus is minus, 3 into 2 is 6, is equal to 14. Transfer this minus 6 to that side, it becomes 40 is equal to 14 plus 6. 14 plus 6. 40 is equal to 14 plus 6 is 20. P is equal to 20 by 4. P is equal to 4 5s are 5. P is equal to 5. 4 1s are 5s are 20. But the answer is not this. We want the value of x. Then what we have to do is But P is equal to 1 by 8, written by us only. We got the value of P as 5. 5 is equal to 1 by x. Cross multiply, 5x is equal to 1, x is equal to 1 by 5. Now we got two values. Therefore, x is equal to 1 by 5 we got. X is equal to 1 by 5. And y is equal to, we already got the value of y. Y is equal to minus 2. Minus 2. This is the answer for question number 3. You have to write and practice. Write and practice. Fourth problem. We are in exercise 3.6, first main question. Reducible form. See the problem. 5 by x minus 1. Denominator, whenever variables are there, they are the reducible. 5 by x minus 1 plus 1 by y minus 2 is equal to 2. 6 by x minus 1. This is also x minus 1. This is also x minus 1. And this is y minus 2. This is also y minus 2. Therefore, what I do is, see, this I write 5. First term, 5 into 1 by x minus 1. Now, 1 by x minus 1, I make it as p. Plus 1 by, this is 1 only, 1 by, 1 by y minus 2 is equal to, this is my first equation. Second equation is, first term is 6 of 1 by x minus 1 minus it is 3 of 1 by y minus 2 equals 1. Equals 1. Now what I do is let P is equal to 1 by x minus 1. P is equal to 1 by x minus 1. Q is equal to 1 by y minus 2. 1 by y minus 2. In the place of 1 by x minus 1, I replace p. 1 by y minus 2, I replace q. Then I get first equation. First equation, 5. In the place of 1 by x minus 1, I write p, 5p. Plus, 1 is there, there is no need to write 1. 1 by q, y minus 2 is equal to q. Is equal to 2. This is my equation 1. Second one is here. 6. In the place of 1 by x minus 1, I replace p, 6p. Minus 3. In the place of 1 by y minus 2, I replace q. Therefore, it becomes 3q. Is equal to 1. This is my equation 2. Now both the equations are ready. We go for elimination. See, when you are doing elimination, always search for easy method. Easy method is that. See, if you want to equate the coefficients of P, then you have to multiply this equation by 6 and this equation by 5. Instead of that one, we eliminate Q. Easy it is. Here 3 is there, here 1 is there. Therefore, if I multiply the first equation by 3, coefficients become same and one is plus, another one is minus. I add that one, I get the answer. Easy method we have to always search. I multiply this one by 3. See, the equation. 3 into 5p, 15p, plus q into 3, 3q, is equal to 2 into 3, 6. First equation is modified. Second equation I write as it is. 6p minus 3q is equal to 1. Now, I equated the coefficient of the value variable q. One is plus is there, another one is minus is there. Then, therefore, I should add this. You should not subtract. Well, subtracting sign changes. Sign changes means you have to add and it becomes 6q. Right? Therefore, we have to add in this. Adding means there is no change of sign. We are not changing the sign.
plus 3 cube minus 3 cube cancels. 15p 6p, 15 plus 6 is 21p is equal to 6 plus 1 is 7. 21p is equal to 7. Therefore, p is equal to 7 by 21. 7 by 21. When we cancel this, 7 1s are 7, 3s are. P is equal to 1 by 3. This is not the answer. With the help of the area of P, again we have to substitute, we can again get an equation, we have to solve it. P is equal to 1 by 3. Now, second part of the problem. Substitute, let the problem it is, substitute P is equal to 1 by 3 in equation 1. Equation 1 also we can do, right? Or equation 2 also, because equation 2 is easy. P is equal to 1 by 3, you can cancel. There we have to take LCM. Therefore, I write 1 only I did. 5P, if you find it difficult to take LCM, go to the equation 2. 5P plus Q is equal to 2. In the place of P, I write what is known as 1 by 3. 5 R of 1 by 3 plus Q is equal to 2. This becomes 5 by 3 plus Q is equal to 2. Is equal to 2. Then what I do is Q is equal to 2 minus, this has to go that side, 5 by 3. 5 by 3. Q is equal to, LCM you have to take. 3 is the LCM, 6 minus 5, 2, 3 is a 6, Q is equal to 1 by 3, Q is equal to what, 1 by 3, we got P also 1 by 3, Q is also 1 by 3, understood? Now what we have to do is, we go for the equation again, but P is equal to, what is the order of P, P is equal to what we have taken, 1 by x minus 1, P is equal to 1 by x minus 1, but P value is 1 by 3, 1 by 3 is equal to 1 by x minus 1, numerator, numerator is same, denominator, denominator is same, therefore what happens, 3 is equal to x minus 1. Now I transfer this minus 1 to this side, 3 plus 1 is equal to x, therefore x is equal to 4, x is equal to 4, I got the value of x. Again, we have to find the value of y, what we have taken, but q is equal to 1 by y minus 2, q is equal to 1 by y minus 2, the value of q is equal to 1 by 3, 1 by 3 is equal to 1 by y minus 2, again numerators are equal, therefore denominator is equal, 3 is equal to y minus 2, I want to transfer minus 2 to this side, therefore it becomes 3 plus 2 is equal to y, therefore y is equal. Y is equal to 5, x is equal to 4 is the answer for this particular problem. Question of first main question of 3.6. See, this problem you see this. Too many complications is given. There are variables in numerator, there is one more variable in the denominator, because the variable x and variable xy are different. X is there, y is there, xy is there, and denominator is there. Therefore, this is a little more steps, see. Finally, what we have to do is, we have to take an equation with two variables. Now, three variables, x, y. First step, we have to cross multiply, there is no way out. We have to cross multiply. 7x minus 2y divided by xy is equal to 5, cross multiply, then it becomes. The first step is 7x minus 2y is equal to 5xy, it becomes 5xy. Second equation becomes, again this here also there is nothing, we can cross multiply. 8x plus 7y is equal to 15xy. The only method is we have to eliminate this xy. We don't like this xy. But how we can eliminate? Divide the whole equation by xy. That's all. Divide the whole equation by xy. Then xy goes here also. Divide the whole equation by xy. Then what happens? It is the first one is 7x divided by xy. Second one, second term, minus 2y by xy is equal to 5xy by xy. The second equation becomes 8x by xy plus 7y by xy, and dividing the equations by xy to eliminate xy, that's all. 15xy by xy. Now I can eliminate. See, elimination. First equation, say x is gone. Here y is gone. Here xy is gone. Same way here. x is gone. Y is gone. xy is gone. Then what is left? The left portion is 8 of, what is the first equation? First equation is this, 7 of 1 by y is left, minus 2 of 1 by x left, because y is cancelled, x is 1 by x. Here I got 5, xy or 5. The second one, 8 of 1 by y plus 7 of 1 by x, 7 of 1 by x is equal to 15, is equal to 15. Now what I do is, let 1 by x is equal to p, I consider 1 by x as p and 1 by y as q, 1 by y as q. Therefore the first equation becomes 7, be careful, 1 by y is there, 7 q minus 2p is equal to 5. Second equation, 8 q plus 7 p is equal to 15. There is no, we can even consider 1 by y as p also, no problem in that. We always keep 1 by x as p, 1 by y as p. Easy to remember, that's all. Now I bring up two equations. First one q, second one is p. This is equation 1. This is equation 2. Right? Now, we have to simplify. What is the which method we go for? You think. We first, this is 7 is there, this is 8 is there. According to principle, this has to be multiplied by 8 and this has to be multiplied by 7. Big number, why to go for bigger number? Smaller number. Here 7 is there, here 2 is there. Therefore, what I do is, I multiply the first equation by 7. 7 is there. I multiply by 7. And I multiply the second equation by 2. Because these numbers are smaller numbers. So, you can take 7 and 8 also. 7 and 2, I take. Now, 7 sevens are 49 cube, be careful, 49, 9 is this cube, 49 cube, minus 14 cube, 14p, 2 into 7 is 14p, is equal to 5 into 7 is 35, 5 into 7 is 35, now 2 into 8 is 16 cube, plus 7 into 2 is 14, 14p equals 15 twos are 30. We have equated the coefficients of P. Now see the sign. One is minus is there, another one is plus is there. You should add this. By adding, we can eliminate. If we subtract, sign changes, then it becomes plus, right? Therefore, we have to add. Adding means there is no change of sign. There is no change of sign. Therefore, I cancel this. Gone. Minus 14 plus 14 is gone. Now we have to add this. 9 plus 6 is 15. 1, 4 plus 1 is 5, 5 plus 1 is 65. 65 cube equals 35 plus 6, 30 is 65. Nice number. 65 cube is equal to 65. I go here. Therefore, Q is equal to 65 by 65. Cancel equals 1. Q is equal to 1. I got the value of Q. Once I get the value of Q, I can find the value of P. So, substitute. Q is equal to 1 in equation 1. Always I go for equation 1 only. First equation is 7q minus 2p is equal to 5. In the place of q, I write 1. Then it becomes 7 half 1 minus 2p is equal to 5. This is 7. 7 minus 2p is equal to 5. I transfer this minus 2p to that side and 5 to this side. On the right hand side, transfer 7 to that side, then it becomes, okay, anything I can do it. If I transfer 7 to that side, 7 becomes minus 7. If I transfer minus 2p to that side, it becomes plus 2p. And 5 on this side means minus 5. Always better to keep it as positive, right? Positive means better to transfer minus 2p to that side, 5 to this side. 7 minus 5 is equal to 2p. 2p transfer that side, it becomes plus 2p, 5 can this side become minus. 7 minus 5 is 2, 2 is equal to 2p, p is equal to 2 by 2, p is equal to 1. Now I got q is equal to 1 and p is equal to 1. But the variation is, I consider this p as 1 by x, q as 1 by 1. Now, after let, but p is equal to 1 by x. P is equal to what? 1 by x. P is equal to 1 by x. What is the value of p? I got 1. 1 by 1 is equal to 1 by x. Always, if denominator is not there, it is better to write 1. If 1 by 1 is equal to 1 by x, therefore x is equal to 1. Numerator is equal to numerator, denominator is equal to denominator. Cross multiply, you get the value. Same way, q is equal to 1 by y. What is the value of q we got? That is also 1. 1 means 1 by 1 is equal to 1 by y. Y is equal to 1. Therefore, we got the value of x is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1. X is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. What you have to do is write them. Solve this problem. These problems having all kinds of mathematical skills. Solving this type of problem, definitely your skill of solving increases, right? Improves. Therefore, do it.